here we are. Just at Grantshouse. Just turned off the A1 there. Strange train. If you're a train fanatic. I don't know quite what it does or what it is. Some kind of maintenance thing. But here we are, so just take a wee donder through the borders on the way home. And I've had dry, but it's still really, really humid. But I don't know if that's dropping or not dropping. Difficult to tell what it's going to do. Just turn this a tad so I can get the wheel turned. Quite a slope here. Right. A bit of brake. Turn. There we go. So, and off we jolly well go. Remember this road particularly. God, I've taken my neck roll off, and I've done nothing. If it rains, I'll just have to pull over and fasten it all back up again. But oh, what a difference. Yeah, good road this is. Takes you to Dunn's, I think. Oh, that's so much nicer. A bit of air. Seen on Facebook there, looks like a blinker down on the 7 at Melville. Oh, there you go. Lovely. Hazy but sunshine, so hopefully it won't rain anymore. Times that should be home for about 3:30. Just take a nice leisurely ride. As ever, always see a foot blast through the borders on the way to the Highlands, and they just discount it. But they shouldn't, because there's some cracking roads in the borders, absolute cracking. And the scenery is lovely too. Lady should be awake from night shift by the time I get home, so me turning up with a bike shouldn't wake her up, and if she's just lying dozing, well, it should wake her up. She was due to get up about 15:20, I think she said. That's lovely. actually. Caught it there, wrong gear, wrong setup, too fast. Never mind. That's where they should have been for that one, yeah. And the thing is, there's no excuse, because there was plenty of lead into it, plenty of time to read and assess it. But still, I was caught out. Happened a couple of times lately, I don't really know why, not normally like that. Hold on a minute. Yeah, looking at the surface, is that this stuff here? Or it's been here? Thought it was there. The centre of the road, it looks like it's here, yeah. Be careful if that's, I'm sure it is. Doesn't seem to be here, mind. Hate that stuff. Gives me the willies. That's the bit I've been on this road in winter in the car, and that's the bit that everybody else is defrosted and it hasn't. See it, eh? There seems to be a lot of crap on the road. Might have been caused by the mega rain yesterday. It's just all accumulated in the centre of the traffic, but not that much traffic on this road. You shall see. Riding like a complete cock. I know the name of this place. That's a good road to Gifford. The line the trees have got because of high sided vehicles. Thank you. sure that kid said hi. Ah, I had a vague recollection of this, yeah. Like the rain itself is breaking up. Let's see. Yes, I think we're going to have to take this one down to the long distance screen. Duns. Nice homes, big, eh? Yeah, yeah. Big houses. Very big. Some of these, look at them, jeez. Come down here and turn right. Yeah. Jim Clark Museum along here. Just set back for the road, just here on the right, I think. There it is. Memory of the great Jim Clark, racing driver extraordinaire, quite a man in his day. Buy that as one house, eh? Oh, we're getting one house. Jeez. Amazing. One wing, you just park your cars and your bikes in the house almost, looks like. Yeah. You have the brand new high school on your left. Very pretty brand new high school, but it's this one here, this building here, the old high school on the right. Look at it, like 1920s or 30s, beautiful, beautiful style. And that's nice, don't get me wrong, more functional. That's more a product of its time, but a beautiful building. I think a lot of the stuff for the 20s and 30s is underappreciated personally, but and some of the stuff for the 70s, horrible as it is in a lot of ways, should be kept and preserved to some extent. This is some examples of it anyway. I wonder how you become familiar with the road. By car, but it seems unfamiliar on a bike. I'm quite familiar with this road. But by car, I'm not familiar with it on a bike. Don't I just look at it differently? I don't know, maybe you do. Made a decision that I absolutely love the sound of this exhaust. It's gorgeous. But it's too loud. And based on that, I've got the baffle. And probably when it comes round MOT time, ask them to put the baffle back in. I'm sure they can weld it. Because for the long run, if it's really loud and about, these long distance ones can be really deafening for hour after hour after hour. Decision's made. So it won't happen immediately, I'll wait till my MOT is due, which is next April. It's the bike's first MOT. And we'll see if we're getting a new baffle. We'll see if we're getting the baffle put back in. Sure what to do with its chains. It's actually survivable because you can have it cracked open like I've got now. Is it cracked open? No, it's not. Let's see what it's here in the lower setting. Mind you, it's not got the whole field crushed. That's bizarre, it's just it's wrong. Duns anyway. Don't know where's next. Greenlaw? Probably is actually, yeah. Greenlaw's next. Slow down, little boy. We don't see that lying in the road every day. Head of a brush. get a wee waft of heat. It's not coming from an engine or anything, it's coming from inside my jacket. It's often as the wind catches the jacket and you get this puff of hot air coming up on the bottom of your neck. Sun visor doing, I think. It turned out not bad after all. Descended down into green lawn now, I think. There's another field completely covered in stuff. Another two, three. Greenlaw, ancient borough town, has a beautiful town hall thing on the left here. I think it's the right place. Get everywhere mixed up. Away we go. That was Greenlaw. Also to our left, but not for us today. Not today. It's 3 o'clock, we're just making our way home. Somewhere between 3:30 and 4. Probably, oh, excuse me. Look at these roads. If you wanted to be naughty, thanks. You could achieve silly speeds really quickly. But that's not for us. No sorry. Arrive alive, and preferably still with a license. Save the speed for overtakes. Turned it nice. Mind you, look at the cloud. I don't know if I set the... I don't know if the camera will actually show it. I've only filmed once or twice with the ghost so far, but each time the sky was just, you know, burnt out type of thing, just white. You couldn't make out any detail in it at all, any cloud or whatever. It's just so bright, it's just burnt it out. So I'll put the exposure at -1. We'll see how it goes. On a nice bright day, it should be just right, I would think. If it's too bright otherwise. I can see. Rumbleton Law. A great name. Rumbleton. Oh, view, eh? Cracking. So what's our annual mileage? Oh, started in February, didn't it? You have to count February. We're at 5,592, so this is 5,600, add up 300, 5,900. There we go, 5,900 for the year so far. This is Gordon. Right to Edinburgh here, left to Kelso. Straight on for Eddleston. I've got a storage problem on my Mac. Mac's got a 1 TB drive. I've got an external, I think it's a 2 TB drive, as a backup drive for Time Machine. I also have a 1 TB drive, various files and things on it. And the main one that I use for the videos is a 4 TB drive. It is now almost completely full. So I went in to try to clean it up a bit, with a view to taking out the original film and just leaving the films I'd made from that. I've done all that, but to be honest with you, it's almost as if I haven't done it, and I don't quite get it. You know, I put them in the trash, it's almost as if I haven't taken them out of the trash. This is gigabyte upon gigabyte. I'm finding it hard to figure out what is causing four terabytes of storage almost eaten up. I can't for the life of me think what the hell it is. Most bizarre. I can't seem to get it. I've mounted it, unmounted it. Deleted all sorts of original film off it. Some of it, like, you know, a couple of gigabytes each time. And I must have taken loads off, at least a terabyte I must have taken off. Yeah, it's still telling me there's 100 megabytes left. Nothing else. Bizarre. Can't understand it. need to buy more storage. Same bar, it's £100, so I can get a 5 terabytes passport for £100, so it's gonna have to be done, I'm afraid. What I might do is change the way I do things as well, because what I might do is bring the films out of the camera instead of putting them straight onto the passport drive. I'll put them onto the Mac drive and I'll use them there, and once they're finished with, I'll move the completed film onto the external drive and delete the original film, because I don't need it, I don't revisit it or anything like that. It's just these rides. So that's what I'm going to do. We'll see how that works out. Either way, I still need to spend £100 on the drive. There's not much more I can delete from the hard drive. Forrest Gump. Slow down, everybody, slow down. Don't wave then. Done today, 97 miles. 100 by the time we get back, 120, something like that. Not bad to get it. Also, about 3 hours overtime. Can't be bad. Oh, getting hot now. -23 degrees it says. Doesn't surprise me. This is a classic coming the long way home. I suppose it is actually, it's quite, could have just went straight back down the road. Oh, hot, hot. So, Edelston. I love the wee tune of Edelston. Thank you. move the bottom a bit. There was an incident one day, where was it? Was it with the PMC? I'll see, it was, we were coming here, we turned into there for some reason, we went just over there, and there was another two bikes there, so it was nothing to do with us. Well, it was some biker's funeral, and they all thought we were there for the funeral. We didn't even, I had no clue who it was, so it was, that was quite funny. You had to be there. I could have been away there, but what the hell. Crying out loud, we'll go now. It's warm now, so our next stop will be Melrose. Gallus Shields after that. Walk a one and a leading and home. That'll probably do it. Interesting to see if the camera's lasted. Very disappointed in the Bluetooth thing. It worked an absolute treat yesterday, and like you say, we just need to get hopefully the drift exchanged or something like that. I mean, it might be something as simple as a cable. And if I was them, I'd send me a new cable first and ask me to try it. Yeah, that's what I would do, send the new cable first. Should we try that? Make sure the cable's not full. And only then would I say, right, well, let's change the camera. Sense. I just hope they're not silly buggers about the fact I can't find the receipt. It's very obvious I bought it direct from them. The delivery receipts and the dispatch receipts, etc. Now we use the camera in this fashion because I think this will work what I'm trying today. I think it'll work. It's a bit of a pain. It's not as flexible. I think it'll work, and I have to look because there's nothing at all on the instructions for that remote about changing the battery. So I will see if that works. Because it might be, you never know, they put these batteries in. It should be watering, guys, crying it loud, surely. There doesn't seem any discernible way to take it apart. There must be a way, because you must replace the battery. So we won't actually see much of Merrows, that's off to our right. Unfortunately, I had to be at the crematorium last week, or this week I should say, but it's unfortunate, never mind. Work colleague. That's Melrose off to our right. This was the line of the old railway line. Nice to overtake. I like overtaking. Very happy to ride at sensible speeds, but I find overtaking fun. In a car, it's nice to look ahead, plan it. Sad but true. Is getting built on Melrose, it'll be a tad pricey, one would think. Tiny bit of bladder stress now, bladder stress, not good. Put this back down. There we go. So, Gala Shields is the next protocol. Acceleration of a bike is intoxicating, and this isn't even a fast bike. That's warm, jinx. Yeah, I thought so. Temperatures went up. This is us coming into Gala Shields. You'd probably say, although Gala Shields does not have the biggest population in the borders, I would say it's the biggest town in terms of what's here for shopping and commercial activity. Actual business activity, could be garlic, could be hollock, I'm quite sure. But in terms of everything else, I think everybody would pretty much agree, except for the vote for hollock, obviously. But garlic pretty much is the centre of the borders. And what we'll do is we'll take you, I wouldn't normally go through the middle of the town, but we will. Just in case there's any viewers that have never been here. Just in case we have any viewers at all. Because we don't know, we might not have. But if you are a viewer and you're still here, thank you. Oh, it's nice and cool under the trees, do you know the difference? Of course, I closed up all the vents. The legs, so the legs are kinda sweaty. See, I'd normally go off to the left there and avoid the town centre. But we'll do this and we'll take you through the town centre so you can see. It's a one-way system, so you can't see much of it unless I go driving round and round to let you see. But no, I'm not going to do. Go off to the left here. Down that way you've got superstores, Asda's and Tesco's, Next, and things like that. Well, this is the actual town centre here. It goes round in a kind of loop and it comes from our right in a one-way circuit. Just the other side of these buildings is another street there, and then the other side of that is the main sort of pedestrianised area. Nice wee town. Used to have, to be honest, I've not walked round Gala just on a whim just to see what the shops are like anymore. Used to take a trip down here from when we lived up in the Lothians. Now I live in the borders, I never come near the place. Except to go to Asda's. That's bizarre. A new kebab shop. Weatherspoons. That's Gala, not quite finished with it. There you go, that's us heading out now. Had we taken a left, back where I mentioned it before, the little roundabout, this is where we would have come out, just here. We would have skipped out all the town, see? It's quite popular, we rode that. So the next stop will be Clovenford, Clovenford Village. But it's just a village, although they've got a lot of new houses there and new school. It's not made it that much bigger. Oof, we actually looked at one of those houses, considered it as a purchase in a new home when we were looking to move down to Borders from the Lothians. But for the money they were asking for, and the house was lovely, you know what I mean, the spec was very nice, but it's like a lot of modern houses, there was virtually no storage space and the rooms were quite small. It had some built-in storage, but god, we're like storeholics. That's an old thing. We could have got by in a house like that. At least we'd have had a big pub or something then. Clovenford Arms, yeah, we'd have had something. A wee tiny shop. Something. That's the only drawback to Cardrona. There's nothing there, nothing. It's just houses. There was a wee tiny village shop at the other end of the village, a half mile walk to the other end of the village. That folded and ended up becoming a cafe, which is very nice that there's something there, but it's not what was needed. It should have been a pub. That's what the village needed, a focal point. Because, I'm sorry, a cafe or a village hall, it's not the kind of focal point a village needs. And a pub would have been a viable option there. Because the path going between Peebles and then leading the cycle path and the walkway, there's traffic along that all year round, especially in the summer. Being ashes is even a pub would have done the same. But then the hotel would have been not happy, the great big golf hotel there, because all the residents would have came out for a beer, because the hotel's extortionate. I've been in it, it's extortionate. It would have been the life and soul of the village, it would have been good. I'd have walked in there for a pint. I know Susan would have joined me, definitely. But never mind. It's done now. They've built homes first. Suppose you need to give people somewhere to live. Yeah, you need to give them somewhere to live. Reminds me of these cars. That was exceeding the speed limit in the built-up area. And then when it could go faster, it doesn't. Bizarre. Happen. The there'll be some kind of comment made, one would imagine, about being out on the bike again. See it coming. I'd be surprised if it isn't, put it that way. Tweed on our left. Well, I remember some years ago, where was it? That car lived in Selkirk at the time. And the rain had been really torrential. I mean, for days, weeks maybe, I don't know. And at the time, I was still working at Dalkeith at the time. And I can't recall why, I had to come along to Barney at some point. College used to be at Barney, and I remember having to come along Tweed Valley here, and it's not somewhere I normally came, and my god, everywhere was underwater. It was unbelievable. The banks had burst all over the place. This is just the surface dressing, but the fine stuff's on it now. It's been there for a few days, so it's not too bad. Kind of fall on one side though. What does it feel like? Can't feel the difference. Go offline and just stick with this outer line, change over if I have to. The stuff. Change over here. It's not as bad as it was. Thankfully, I came a lot in the car. I was first done with the big chips. It was brutal. Of course, the buses and the trucks don't care. They're just fleeing along the road. Stones flying all over the place. The worst part of the corners, because everybody takes a different line, so the stuff tends to spread out in the corners, and there is no safe part. I'm just going to stick on the inside here, which is not where I'd normally be. So that bit in the middle, that's the bit that you've got to watch out for. So that can often spread out on the corners. We'll see. The end is just not far away. We came down this way yesterday, obviously going opposite way, heading down to Alston, and it was so wet you couldn't see. There you go, that's ended. You couldn't see where the sort of humps of gravel were, because it was a darn different, sort of the same colour. Fast for the sake of going fast, but come overtaking time, let's not hang about. Let's do it as quick as we can, because it's safer. 39. It's not me. It's pointing up there because it always gets you outside the speed limit. So it's not me. Walkabout. 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 This is Walkabout. Almost bought a house here too, just back there on the left. And what was this attractive feature? It looked like it was actually two houses dumped into one. And downstairs it had a fully functioning sauna and a massive kitchen that actually had granite worktops. Real granite worktops. Let's see beyond that. I didn't rate it particularly. Well, that's choice here. There we go. Yeah, beyond the fully functioning sauna and the granite worktops in the kitchen, it was nothing special. Actually, a lot of them had plain wooden floorboards, which were horrible. Bedrooms were not a lot of storage, if any. Tune of Annalethan and St. Ronan's Wells. Whew, hot, 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 hot. That was that then. Annalethan and St. Ronan's Wells. Done. Next stop, Cardrona. Our wee village, the Shire. Nice wee village, lovely place to live. There's a golf course that goes around the village, that's around the village. Lovely and quiet most of the time. So much so that there is a loud noise or something like that, you tend to notice it. But beyond that, the downside to it is that there's nothing there, like I said before. That's the only downside to it. I mean, if you want a pint of milk, you have to go online to Asda's or something like that, or you have to get in a car and go and get it. You can't just walk to get a pint of milk. Which is, that's the downside for me. I mean, it would be nice, I'd love to be with them walking distance of a pub. I'm not a great drinker, I don't socialise, but I don't know, I'd like to go out sometimes, you know, with the wife, sometimes without the wife, but that's a bus up to Peebles, a taxi back, or whatever. Ugh. You know, that's bloody 20 odd quid on the night out. It's nuts. Just through the trees and across the Tweed. It's Cardrona. Mega money in some of them, look at them. You're talking 750,000. Overlooking the golf course, empty buildings in front of you, overlooking the river, but at a distance. Mega money. Beautiful homes. Must admit, with all the faults I mentioned about Cardrona, it's a beautiful place to live. And if I came into money, I'd quite happily buy a bigger house in a different part of Cardrona. Nuts. There's the McDonald Golf Hotel. That has the golf course that surrounds the village. It literally does go round the village. So here we are. If we go straight ahead, about 4 miles ahead of us, you've got Peebles. Like I say, we're going into the Shire. Cardrona. So, we'll call it a day as we turn into my village. Tweed on the left, new builds where the pub should have been, McDonald Cardrona Hotel. And I say cheery bye. See you another day.